you stay focused on your dream and your objective that you started out with, you won't let naysayers or anybody deter you from getting to your objective, because you can lose your objective. You start out running well, but who did hinder you? And so if God has placed this thing inside of you, I heard Miles Monroe teaching this morning, and he put up a little pack of seeds. No, Bill Winston as well too. He had a little pack of seeds, and then he said, well, he forgot his seeds, but he said, I was intending to bring an apple. And so what he did, he said, when you cut the apple open, you can cut it in four segments. He said, inside that apple is four seeds, kind of dark looking seeds. He said, a tree is in that seed. An apple is in that seed. The peeling, the outer covering is all in that seed. And I was like, okay, yeah, we know that. And then he went on to say this. He said, now, as the apple, so are you, and so are we. He said, now, we're not trying to get where God, see, most time I was thinking we're trying to get there. No, he said, the seed is already inside of you. So if the seed is in the apple and it produces a tree, come on now, that same thing is already inside of you. It's now. It's not coming in. So he just trying, he said, to stir you that you can let the seed grow and germinate and become that which you already are. You're already rich and already successful. But sometimes we just don't know that yet. Because why? We're not looking at the seed. See, you don't have to do anything for the seed. The God is saying there's no toil in what I'm trying to show you. He said, as a man put seed in the ground, rose night and day. It was no toil in that. All it was, he had to put the seed in the ground because the ground knew what to do with it. And God is saying the same thing to us. If we let him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, project and show us the path that he's already ordained for us to walk in. Come on, man. Let me tell you something. I was talking to a guy last night, man. We was up the other night to 3 o'clock in the morning. And I had been talking to him, man, for 6 months, trying to tell him and show him what I was doing. But he thought I didn't have no game. He thought I didn't have no game, because I was just, everybody. Every time I come into a group of people, they always count me out because I guess I just got that dumb look. I guess I don't know what it is, and so we did. They do. They always count me out. I'm saying, I'm not the guy that's gonna be up there with y'all at the top. Blah, 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 blah. Everybody does that to me, but that's my sauce because see, I'm the guy that observing. Duplication is everything. You can copy somebody. That Torrey Phillips talking about the copycat on Premiere, he said, but you got to copy the right cat so the Holy Spirit will let you go there, man. And so here we are. So when you humble yourself and be quick to forgive people, man, let me tell you, I can't say that one enough. Be quick to forgive people. Somebody stuck me in the back the other day. I like, man, and it hurt so bad, but then what rose up inside of me was a song. I could hear it singing inside of me. I like, wow. I said, this is pretty awesome. And so here it is, your dream, your goal, and your vision. If you stay focused on those two things, regardless of, because you waited on God. He said, the earth know what to do with it. And God will do it to you. God will do it for you. So I'm up there this morning toiling, not toiling, but I was thinking, this is what the Lord gave me. This is what he gave me. I put it, I said, I texted it to me. This is what he texted. This is what I said. This is what he said. He said, the word of the Lord came to me. This is what he said. He said, when the time is right, I, the Lord, will make it happen. Isaiah 60 and 22. When the time is right, I, the Lord, will make it happen. And I was toiling, I was going through there, not toiling, but then that word, boom, it jumped out at me. I said, okay, here we go. So now we on the launch pad, we're getting ready to take off, And so the pilots are checking everything, just checking all the instruments, the engines are revved up, and they're just waiting on a word from the tower control, whatever you call it. And they was giving you to give you the clearance to go. And I'm coming to tell you, God has given us the clearance to go. And if you let him, if you stay in that circle of influence, or stay in that community of people that he got you in, you're gonna take off from the place that you are today. Come on now. It may not look like much right now. Come on, come on, come on. I feel that thing. It may not look like much right now, but you ain't doing it. He's doing it. And you will take off into your wealthy place. I posted a video. And so when you take off, you climb. So you got to go through resistance to keep climbing till you get to that right attitude. And once you get to the altitude that God has called you to at this age bracket that we're in, let me tell you something, you'll level off. Then the pilot will come on and say, all right, you can take your seatbelts off, you can get up and move around. And that's what we're going to that altitude, getting up so we can what? Move around. And when we start moving around in the Holy Ghost, and that's going to be like it was in the latter years of the early part of our ministry, it's going to be some power and demonstrations of over satanic forces in the darkness as we begin to proclaim this gospel of Jesus Christ in a dynamic way. Not like it was before. Because now we're seasoned with salt. Preparation has brought us to this place, and now we're resting in what God is going to finish the work in our lives. And we'll go out in a
Man.
battle. I had a video this morning I was watching. They had these, it was the 100-yard dash. They had a 91-year-old, 85, 86, 84. Look, and I like, I'm starting to keep on going, but then I said, come on, wait a minute now. And when they hit that gun, look here, they come on down through that too. So look here, they were getting it, boy. They were running like some 30, 40-year-olds. I said, come on, boy. I posted that on my Facebook page. See, come on. Cause see, and that's what I'm trying to show you this morning, but look like they ain't gonna come. So man, I'm pumped. Because I'm telling you, man, if you can see this thing, if you can see where you're going from here, and don't be distracted by what the enemy's gonna try to take, man, let me tell you something. I said, man, come on, man. Multi-million-dollar ideas are coming to us, man, because it's ordained for us to be here, man. God calls us here.
It might have been, as you've been working toward that dream that you're holding in your mind, that it's possible. That some of you already know that it's hard. It's not easy. It's hard changing your life. That in the process of working on your dreams, you are going to incur a lot of disappointment, a lot of failure, a lot of pain. There are moments when you're going to doubt yourself and say, God, why is this happening to me? I'm just trying to take care of my children and my mother. I'm not trying to steal or rob from anybody. Why did this have to happen to me? For those of you that have experienced some hardships, don't give up on your dream. Their rough times are going to come, but they have not come to stay. They have come to pass.
Greatness is not this wonderful, esoteric, elusive, godlike feature that only the special among us will ever taste. You know, it's something that truly exists in all of us.
It's very important for you to believe that you are the one. Most people, they raise a family, they earn a living, and then they die. They stop growing, they stop working on themselves, they stop stretching, they stop pushing themselves. That a lot of people like to complain, but they don't want to do anything about their situation. And most people don't work on their dreams. Why? One is because of fear. The fear of failure. What if things don't work out? And the fear of success. What if they do and I can't handle it? These are not risk takers.
You spend so much time with other people. You spend so much time trying to get people to like you. You know other people more than you know yourself. You've studied them. You know about them. You want to hang out like them. You want to be just like them. And you know what? You've invested so much time in them, you don't know who you are. I challenge you to spend time by yourself.
It's necessary that you get the losers out of your life if you want to live your dream. But people who are running toward their dreams, life has a special kind of meaning.
When you become the right person, what you do is you start separating yourself from other people. You begin to have a certain uniqueness. As long as you're following other people, as long as you're being a copycat, you will never, ever be the best copycat in the world. But you will be the best you could be. I'm challenging you to define your value.
That everybody won't see it. That everybody won't join you, that everybody won't have the vision. It's necessary to know that you are an uncommon breed. It's necessary that you align yourself with people and attract people into your business who are hungry, people who are unstoppable and unreasonable, people who are refusing to leave life just as it is and who want more. The people that are living their dream of finding winners to attach themselves to. The people that are living their dreams of a people that know that if it's going to happen, it's up to them.
If you want to be more successful, if you want to have and do stuff you ain't never done before, number two, I'm asking you to invest in you. To invest in you.
Someone's opinion of you does not have to become your reality. That you don't have to go through life being a victim. And even though you face disappointment, you have to know within yourself that I can do this. Even if no one else sees it for me, I must see it for myself.
This is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it. Period.
No matter how bad it is or how bad it gets, I'm going to make it.
I want to represent an idea. I want to represent possibilities.
And some of you right now, you want to be, you know what I'm saying? You want to go to the next level. I want to counsel. You know, I want to be an engineer. I want to be a doctor. Listen to me. You can't get to that level. You can't get to the level economically where you want to be until you start investing in your mind. You're not reading books. I'm challenging y'all to go to conferences. I dare you to invest time. I dare you to be alone. I dare you to spend an hour getting to know yourself. When you become who you are, when you become the person that you were created to be, designed to be who you were designed to be, when you become an individual, what you do is you take yourself and you start separating yourself from other people. I challenge you to get to a place where people don't like you, it don't even bother you no more. Why? Because you're not concerned with trying to make them happy, because you're trying to blow up. You're trying to get to the next level. I need you to invest in your mind. Invest in your mind. If you still talk about your dream, if you still talk about your goal, but you have not done anything, just take the first step.
That you can make your parents proud, you can make your school proud, you can touch millions of people's lives, and the world will never be the same again because you came this way. Don't let nobody steal your dream. After we face a rejection and a no, or we have a meeting and no one shows up, or somebody say, you can count on me, and they don't come through. What if we have that kind of attitude? The car's repossessed. Nobody believes in you. You've lost again and again and again. The lights are cut off, but you're still looking at your dream, reviewing it every day, and say to yourself, it's not over until I win. You can live your dream.
All right.
All right, ain't it? While I was listening to that, tears was coming down my eyes. I was crying. The tears running down my eyes while I was watching that, because I have watched that for years so many times. And then sitting in this very place where I am right now, you know, 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, man, you know, Lord, how much, you know, and tears running down my eyes, seeking God, calling out, man, Lord, what is it? Why I can't see it? Why it ain't happening for me? Why I see it happening for everybody? What's blocking me? What's stopping me from seeing the vision and the dream and the potential that you placed in me? Why what's hindering me from going to the next level of success with a multi-million-dollar idea? Come on now. And so what's my problem? Because I know it ain't you. I know it ain't your word. I know it ain't the Holy Spirit. So open my eyes and let me see what I can't see. And so here we are today, man. I tell you. And if you never ask a question, you never get an answer. So we got Brother StreamYard. Let me find him. Where he's at? Sometimes he's be hiding from me. Can y'all see that? Hold on.
Not yet.
Not yet. Let me share my screen. We got Brother StreamYard. Where he's at right there? So now you know we are still going back to the simple things of repetitiveness, you know, because what you do.
Hey,
excuse me.
Hey, Wayne, send the link to that video. It's good to have in the library.
Oh, okay. I'll do it right now. Let's go. Let me see if I can get that. Yeah, you want to do it now? Or you want me to? I'll send it to you
No, after you after finish the training. Your okay. presentation. Yeah.
Okay, great. I'll send it to you. So,
let me ask you a quick question.
Let's talk a little bit. I feel like we need to talk a little bit because I think we got something to say about vision. I just kind of feel like vision and provision, you know, because we need to just chat here a few minutes because visionaries have visions and provisions are made or given by God. And as we sit in this place looking for a panel, looking for the panel that God has for us, that panel means he may bring some more people alongside you to help you. See what I'm saying? To get you to a place of excellence. And once you, you know, and so this place that he's already ordained for us to be who we are, to go where we are called to go.
Amen.
Yeah, I agree. I think you said it in the beginning. I think the provision is already here. I think that we just, like I said, like the seed is in the apple. And the thing of it is that we have to get that seed in our heart. And in our heart, we believe that, you know, that it's here, that it is here. And once it's sown in our heart and it began to grow and develop in our heart, all of the things that is necessary for the seed to grow, they manifest on, you know, paraphrasing or putting it in an analogy form, everything that is supposed to be produced, everything that the tree need, everything that we need is already provided by God. You know, it's like the earth is already given for the seed to be sown in. You know, and everything around it, water, rain, whatever it needs, God has already got it there. It's just us having that belief in our heart. It got to be in our heart, not just in the head alone. It's got to be in our heart that this is it. This is the dream. This is the vision, and the provision is just waiting on us to follow the steps, do the process, do what is right in the process. It's automatic, really. You know.
Yeah. So true. So
amen.
So very true.
So you know, there was some things, high pointers that the video brought out, and nothing that was stated is anything we haven't heard. But faith cometh, you know, not by having heard, but having heard, present tense. And I know I was talking with the Holy Spirit a couple days ago. And in Sunday's teaching, I reminded, we're studying the life of Joseph. And I've been teaching on Joseph for months and just exegeting a Bible of Joseph's life and how it progressed to the materialization and realization of the dream that he had. And as I was teaching, the Lord reminded me, I was emphasizing the evidence of God being with you.
Yeah.
So God was with Joseph.
Right.
And he prospered. Well, how do you know God was with Joseph? Anytime God is with an endeavor, there will always be seasonal increase.
Seasonal increase.
And always. It don't always come at the same time. There are intervals. And I think I've shared this. I've shared this with you, Herman, and I'm gonna share it with Wayne. And years ago, and this lesson, you know, God gives us lessons through life experiences that stay with us for a lifetime. Well, this is one of those classic lifetime lessons. I was in an auto accident in Daphne years ago, caused me to be off of work for 3 months. Just going through therapy and back and forth. But here's the point of emphasis. while we were praying at my home on our regular devotion time on a Wednesday night, the Holy Spirit gave a word of wisdom in the through the vehicle of prophecy during that time. And he said, the car is paid for. Now understand, I wrecked the car. I was not at fault, sandwiched in, but it was total and it still had notes on it, at least a year more.
Yeah.
And my reaction was anger. I said, this ain't fair. Lord, I don't even have a vehicle. I was without transportation. That was the only vehicle I had. It was total and still with notes.
Yeah.
And so I complained. I murmured. And daddy just let me did it. Went on that little tangent. And as soon as I settled my emotions, he said, but, you know, you got to pay the bill. I said, that just ain't fair. I don't even have a car I'm paying on. I ain't got four wheels that I've got to pay. You know, teaching me integrity and how to stay the course. But anyway, here's the word that came forth that night. He said, the car is paid for. And I just hesitated. I said, huh? Car is paid for? So we had a little dialogue. I said, Lord, you know, in my world, my way of thinking, you tell me something is paid for, that means I don't have to make any more payments, right? Wrong. I said, well, you said it's paid for, but I still got to send these monthly payments. I don't understand. Just blew my circuit.
Yeah.
I couldn't wrap around that. It's paid for. So anyway, he never answered me. He never gave me no explanation for one solid year. I mean, no more discussion. I've told you it's paid for. Now, you can be analytical. You can be come here and think you're going to interrogate me and force me to answer and tie my hands. You ain't going to do it. So anyway, after a period of time, weeks, I realized, God, I had known him well enough to know when there's no answer. One of two reasons, because if I told you the answer, you wouldn't comprehend it. You perhaps wouldn't even believe it. So I'm not wasting my time trying to give you something that you will not receive. And, you know, I might as well face the truth. The way that worked out, I wouldn't have received it. Well, a year later, I made my last payment. I get in the mail, you know, in the mail, the title. Car's mine. Phew. Car's mine, but I ain't had no physical car for a whole year. I mean, the thing was tore up, but I got the title deed to it. Yes, what a relief. What a relief. Well, that was on a Wednesday. The title deed came. Friday, a check came in the mail, right at $231. From the company, finance company that it was financed through. Now I'm totally messed up. What? What are they doing sending me money back? Sent two. That's the first check for $200-something. And while in prayer, the Lord said, give that to your wife. I said, give it to my wife. I need that pocket change. He said, give that to your wife. So I gave it. I said, look, give it to my wife. So I gave it to her. He said, now the next check gonna be bigger, that's yours. I said, okay. So I gave it to her. I said, now the Lord told me now, he said, checks are coming. That's how he put it, checks are coming. He said, now the next check, son, is yours. It's gonna be bigger. I said, okay. So I told my wife, now don't you come holding your hand out for the next time, because the Lord has said, that's mine. And you ain't getting it, you ain't getting it. Because these wives love to hold their hand out. You know, where mine? Get my hand. You know, you ain't getting no half of this. So anyway, the next week, Friday, another check came in the mail from the same Capital One Finance Company. $432. I said, Lord, what in the world is going on?
Yeah.
I said, nobody gonna believe this. So I copied the checks to make sure I keep it in a file as a reminder. The next week, God said, more checks are coming. Another check came. This time it increased an increment of over $200. So that was $600 some dollars. I said, what is going on? Still, God didn't answer. Next week, another check came, four in a row. That was $800 some dollars. Now, that was the last one for that season, but God said, now, one is coming for six figures. So I didn't bother about it. I said, okay, you've been faithful in this. I know you'll be faithful in due time in that, because ain't no way that my mind could have wrapped around how God was going to fulfill his word. Didn't I tell you? It was paid.
Amen.
The amount that he sent back was over and beyond what I had paid that whole year. It came back, but never would I have even, in a whole lifetime, ain't no way I could have figured out how God was going to do that.
That's right.
In a lifetime, I never would have figured it out. So he didn't waste the time trying to tell me. But then I'll tell you something else, Wayne and Herman, from that point on, I learned the principle. I learned how God functions in the kingdom. I said, oh, you know, it ain't that I hadn't heard it before. You call things that are not as though they were. So I told my, I said, you backpedal and we go forward and you backpedal. So I told my daughter when she built her first home there in Georgia. I said, bring your deeds. You know, like 300 some thousand dollars, whatever it was. And I said, we're going to declare this house is paid for up front. I said, how does it feel to have a paid for house? Well, that feel real good. But now understand the principle of the word is paid for. It's in reality paid for. But you got to backpedal. You got to send them notes in every month. But understand, if God is with you and for you, and he is, and now he's a partner with this, that house note belonged to him. You just going to be an instrument. He going to make sure it's paid, make sure the money come in. I said, but understand, your testimony is, as of this day, when we put our laid hands on that, I said, it's paid for this day. Not 3 years from now.
Yeah.
20 years from now. It is done today. Signed, sealed, delivered. And so I begin to practice all of my financial dealings God's way. But that was just a blessing to me to learn the ways of God in reference to that classic example. And I never have forgotten how to make application to that. Can't hear you, Wayne.
Prophet Callie, I'm just talking to him.
I'm sorry.
He's coming in. Okay, all right, bro. So true. So here we are, and I feel like the next level of success is going to be here, with the network. So this is our television network here. This is WJM TV, and so this is what it looks like when you go to it, streaming 24/7.
So, pastors and choirs from all over the country. Today is no different.
Yeah,
check out this sermon from one of our incredible ministry leaders.
Hello. My name is Pastor Wayne Johnson. I'm here in our sanctuary tonight. And the reason I'm talking to you is because of George Sanders and the Daily Gospel Network. I was struggling trying to figure out how do we grow our ministry in 2022. COVID has really changed the game. And then I came across George Sanders. And I'm telling you, man, this guy is awesome. He has an entrepreneurial mindset. He has a great understanding of the digital ministry and digital media that will blow you away. And if you want to take your church to a new level, you want to take your business to a new level, let me tell you something. The Daily Gospel Network and Mr. George Sanders is one of the tools and one of the doors God has opened to us to bring us into knowledge and understanding of how to move in a digital platform and a digital season that we're living in right now. And I'm so glad that I'm a part of the Daily Gospel Network. I'm so glad that I'm a friend of George Sanders, and I just want to let you know, come and join George Sanders and the Daily Gospel Network. It will really bless your ministry and bless your life. Take care.
Hi, Welcome to our broadcast, part two, with Dr. Ruben McMillan, the Kingdom Prescription. And Dr. Ruben, it's just a pleasure to be here with you today. And
so that's the place. So here it is, you know, so back 2021, 2022, 23, now we're in 24. So, you know, here it is, the training process. So back here. So 2021, 2022, 2023, and 2024. That's almost over three years of training, having access to a mentor. And so now that gives me the ability to duplicate what my mentor was doing. And so I call it spirit. So whenever you catch the spirit of an entrepreneur, you start to produce in a totally different manner. That's what you want to do. So here it is. When you catch the spirit, when the spirit of God comes upon you, he empowers you to do things that are intangible, impossible in your life, just like you talked about the car. So here it is, taking you to another level, taking you to a total place of success and not failure. Because see, if you ever taste this market, if you ever can see it for what it really is, and the curtain be pulled back and you can see it, like I was telling my friend the other night, I said, man, George got 350 subscribers on his network, just on the network alone. At $149, it's the lowest price that you pay. You don't have to do any editing. They'll pull your stuff off of Facebook, you know, and then you can upload it. But the quality and the professionalism is second to none. So if my mentor Duke is performing on that level, so what level you think I'm going to be performing on the same level?
Yeah.
And when you do that, let me tell you something. When you do that and you go to the next level, because everything, when you come on a Zoom or any StreamYard, you want to be tight. You know, you want to be tight, like my backdrop. You want it to be tight because you come to make a statement. And it's not hard to do this, but you know, when you come out, you want to be on that. You want to be on that mark. Yeah. So took a lot of embarrassing hits to get here. 21, 22, 23, 24. You know, I've come on and none of my stuff worked. Looked terrible or embarrassing. I just wanted to go lay down and hide in the corner and quit. Trying to do some audio, terrible, rah, 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 video, terrible, blah, 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 blah. And just so embarrassing. So many times I can tell you I did that and it was just terrible. But, you know, I didn't quit. That's why I was showing y'all that dream about the vision, the dream. And if you don't quit, let me tell you something. One day you'll come up and you'll be able to do and set yourself apart on some stuff, because through the heartache and through the pain, we know what you are. You are an enduring force that God has gifted. See, it's not given to those that start out and quit them, you know, because they don't see the importance of it. Then therefore they long-term goals and objective won't be reached, because they stopped at the finish line. They got off the finish line, but then they stopped. And so here it is, it's gonna pay me great dividends to continue doing what I'm doing. It's going to bring a lot of success in my life, because why, man, doors are finna open for me. If there's no resistance, there's no pain, there's no trouble, man, let me tell you something. In your wilderness moments is where you're going to be built to be successful. It's going to culturally change your mentality, because if this doesn't change, come on now, you still the same old Joe Blow. Because why? Culturally, we are walking in cultural mindsets from a community perspective. The way our community thinks, it's the way we think. And so you got to go outside of that in order to get a intellectual perspective about the market and the place you're trying to tap into. So you got to get that from a different source, because you can't get it from the source you're in, because if you would, you already be walking in. And that means that you are not. So that means that it's not going to come from the source, but it's the raven that God would have put into your put in place that you can tap into. So something that he's already given you. And so here it is. And so exposure will come through people that God will place in your life. Because why? He's going to culturally change your mindset. He's going to culturally let you see something and understand some things that has been blocking the success of ministry, financial prosperity, and everything that you need that's already inside of you. It's been blocking because of mindset. This here is blocking, has blocked us from going to the level that God calls us to go to. See, the raven comes, a raven means provision. And God provide provisions for those that would let him do it. Makes sense? Because you got to let him change you. Because culturally, we got a preconceived idea, just like I did, man. I'm like, man, how do I go to this level? I ain't never been here before. And nobody was going to choose me. they're not choosing me. I guess I got a dumb look on my face. They're not going to choose me. But then here it is. God has chosen me before the foundation of the world. Now he's illuminated my mind and gave me clear understanding of how to do what I'm doing. And I was a coward when I started in 2021. I didn't have the courage and the ability to do what I'm doing now. But through protocol and proper training and discipline and being laughed at, I don't know how many times, cried a lot of time, man, just sitting in this chair, riding down the street, man, you know, pulling up that video, man. I probably listened to that video. I don't know. I can't count the times I listened to it. Never was there, but now I'm here. So what I'm trying to tell you guys, don't let nobody steal your dream. I don't care who they are. I don't care how young they are. I don't care how, no. That's for, you know, no. And so once I understood that, man, let me tell you something. I stopped trying to make it happen and just let God do what he's already given me, because he's already given me that thing which pertains to life and godliness. And now say my skill set. So now StreamYard is the platform. Well, you may say, well, I don't have the skill set like Bishop. Nah, it's already there. It's coming. All you got to do is be patient. And ask the Holy Spirit to open your eyes and open you and show you what he showed me. And all of a sudden, one day you'll boop, and all that, when you go on StreamYard, all that stuff, boop, it'll open up just like that, and you'll see everything. And you'll be able to do some of the stuff that I'm doing. Easy, with no talk. And that's the thing that I had to understand, had to wait on the Lord and be inquire of him. And because, you know, in 1 Chronicles 14, I think David inquired of the Lord twice. He said, when the Philistines saw that God had blessed David and now he was king over all of Israel, and he had built goodly houses, here come the Philistines. They're coming. And God, they came out. David heard they were coming. He prepared for battle. And the Bible said they brought the ephod, and he said he inquired of the Lord. He asked two questions. Can I go out, and will you deliver them into my hand? And God said yes to the first question. Sometimes, you know, and so he said yes to the second question. They were successful. Then the enemy came back and regrouped. Same enemy now. And here's David again. He inquired of the Lord, bring me the ephod. Most times when we go out and have a victory, we just go out and duplicate the same thing we did last time, right? Come on now. So you're looking at a man that did that. So we go back, just keep doing what we've been doing, and we keep doing what we've been doing, because we won last time. We'll keep on this strategy. No, but you got to go back and inquire of the Lord. David went back and inquired of the Lord. I went back and inquired of the Lord. And this is what the Lord told David. He said, even though they're coming, he said, do not go to the same place in the open battlefield like you did last time. And he asked the question, can I go? Will you deliver them to my hand? And God said, no. He said, now go by the city of Ziz and hold by the mulberry tree and wait on me. Here you got young generals. You got all kind of people. How stupid is this? We holding by the mulberry tree. We done beat them down last time. Come on now. And so here it is. We go back with, I'm talking about me going back with the same mindset that, you know. And so here it is. But God said, hold by the mulberry tree. He said, but when you hear the marching in the top of the march in the mulberry trees, that's the army of God going to the battlefield before they physically get there. He said, when you hear that marching in the top of the mulberry tree, you know I have went before you. And so if he goes before us, there's no toil. But if we go before him, Come on now. That's when we got tall. Come on. He said, wait. And David waited. Saul didn't wait. See, Saul did not wait. David waited. And when they did, they went to the battlefield and slaughtered their enemies. And then you read in the scripture where the Philistines didn't come back after that second beating. And so here we are. We're going to the next level of success in our life and what we are trying to accomplish here. And this TV network, the WJM TV, man, I'm just trying to show you. Content is content creation. That's what you want to focus on. You want to focus on content creation. Now you want to get this thing to the platform where we can start launching it on this network. So hungry souls and people can begin to see and discern that this season of the 7,000. Because see, God is calling men back to the place of discipline and character and credibility in the ministry. And so people need to see that. They need to hear that. They need to understand that the message hasn't changed and the messengers haven't changed. And we are here not bowing the knee to Baal, but we're coming in operating in the thing that God has already gifted us in. Come on now, from an excellent platform. And when we do that, you know, we just let the Lord and the Holy Spirit have his way among the people. And because you influence your name recognition and your branding is already there. And so here we are. We just bringing up the 7,000, our army of men and women that's going to walk in love and walk in the ability of the kingdom from a prophetic standpoint, as we let the Holy Spirit bless, empower us to show us the principles of seed time and harvest and accessing kingdom blessings. You know what I'm saying? Accessing kingdom blessings and seeing it come to pass, you know, speedily, you know, sowing a first fruit offering, or whatever, $1,000 offering. And all of a sudden, that $1,000 offering opens the window of heaven. And here it is, bam, that thing which is missing now becomes the fulfillment of what God is calling me to do. And so when we operate from that thing, you know, and I'm going to say this, and we got about 10 minutes. The old landmarks are the proper way that we begin to see the miraculous take place in our life. The Bible says he gives seed to the sower and bread to the eater. Now, back in the day when the church was really poor, didn't have any money, what did they do? They made a pledge. They said, well, I want to sow $1,000, but I don't have $1,000. And they made a pledge. They made a vow to the Lord. They said, Lord, if you give me the $1,000, I'll sow it. He's going to give seed to the sower that want to sow, but you don't have it now. And when God put that money in your hand, it will surely be, because he always keeps his word. So when you sow that $1,000, that seed will produce another hundredfold. Because what? He gives seed. He didn't give you seed. Now you sow the seed where he tells you to sow it. Now that hundredfold, come on now, it will produce a hundredfold on your life. And so sometimes, you know, like, you know, we forget those principles of seed time and harvest. Because why? You know, we drift away from the principal things of patterns of God, and now we start doing something else. You know, because I'm a perfect example, you know what I'm saying? And so here it is, go back to the thing, because I'm going to get. Let me say this right here. My brother had I had an old air conditioner I had bought years ago, man. I tell you, because I was buying rental property and all that stuff. And I was over there with my dad, and this lady had upgraded. She's a realtor, and I did some work with her. I had bought no property from her, but anyway, my dad was working. So she upgraded her AC unit. It was a 5-ton unit with the air handler, and the old unit was still good, but she was upgrading, you know, putting a new unit in there. So I was over there, and so I bought the old unit from her, I think maybe $200-$300, wasn't nothing. So I put it down there in the shop with my brothers and them. And so here it is, my brother had been down there for years. So he building a new house. He'd been remodeling the house, and upgraded the house. So he said, I want to put that AC unit. He said, that unit been down, that's good. He said, how much you want for it? So he trying to bargain with me, you know. I said, how much you give me for it? You know how that go. So, you know, he wanted at a discount price, so he won't offer me a price. So I said, I don't know. And a $600 number popped up in my mind. Boom. I said, give me $600 for it. It's worth $1,500. I said, boy, you got a good product there. He was smiling. Yeah, boy, you can tell he got a deal. And so, and I could hear the Spirit of the Lord. He said, will you give that 600 to me? I'm about like, you know, I said, Lord, I just got your 600. I got some stuff I want to do. And I sensed that God was asking me a question. And so he said, so it was about a month, 6 weeks before he gave the money. He said, well, I'm going to pay you. I said, well, do you still want the unit? So last Sunday at church, he gave it to me. And as soon as he gave me that check, I took it and put it in the envelope and put it on the first fruit offering. And I licked it and took it in there and put it in the secretary office. And let me tell you something, man. Let me tell you what happened. The next morning, the other morning, I got up, and Gary Conceive, I don't know if you watch him or not, and he talks about finances and money. I'm sitting there watching Gary Conceive. I've been watching Gary Conceive for years, and I got his books and his tapes. I'm sitting there eating my cereal the other morning. And all of a sudden, I could feel the Spirit of God. This guy's talking about, he said, when the anointing came on his life, because he struggled for so many years, he said, the power of God came in the service. He said, when it came on that money, come on now. And God just, that power, the Holy Spirit came upon the money. And he's talking about how they went to another meeting and the power of God came upon the money. He said, when he took the money back to the church and gave it to the secretary, hear me now. He said, when the lady opened the bag, he said the power of God hit her and she was slain in the spirit, crying and weeping and sobbing. And another lady came and looked in the bag and the same power came on her and slayed her in the spirit. And, and she calling Gary and telling him all of these things. As I was listening to that, I could feel the Spirit coming and it got so strong it almost knocked me in the floor and it just took my breath. My breath almost left me and I'm sitting up there, man, it overshadowed me. And I said, Lord, my first fruit and the gift that I gave at that Sunday service, I went to a Sunday service and the man of God said, Roko Shelema. He said, Namaka. When you give to a prophet, you share with what receive a prophet's rewards. And that first fruit offering that I gave, let me tell you something, that anointing came upon me again. God has blessed me three times supernaturally in my life where so much money has come to me and I just couldn't explain it. And I was, and so here it is. I asked him for the fourth season, for the fourth time, for this final blessing to flow into my life again. And all of a sudden, I rakita. And I've been through hell now. Don't get me wrong. Now, I'd have paid a heavy price for this thing. The last 2 and 3 years been hell. And here it is. Now the ability of the kingdom has rested upon my life. Now we go into this place here, man. Come on now. This network and all of the stuff that God is opening up doors to take place right now. And I'm just telling you, man, I'm just here. Like I told my boy last night, I said, man, look here. I said, what you don't see is you probably, this thing, what you're going through, it's probably going looking at a bit, you know. I told him, I said, God, I could see you going to $30,000 a month with what you already got. Now, when I say $30,000 a month, you can't imagine that. So here it goes, you know. So now, then you go $30,000 a month, you know, $100,000 a month income. You know, we're making $100,000 a month. So you don't even fathom that number. So when God started to tell us things, man, you know, so you got to be very, and so it's not for everybody, but it's for the few people that can grasp in this season what the Holy Spirit want to do in our life. Does that make sense?
Amen.
And so take your teaching, capture it, 28 minutes, 30 seconds, cut it to where you want it, and start archiving it. Like I told you, Brother Joe, go get that standalone hard drive, a 4-trig or 6-trig, and start putting your stuff in there in a folder for each month. Put your sermons in there as they leave. You may have 10 sermons in that for this month, or April or whatever, May, and you put your sermons in there and create content. Create content, because let me tell you something. You're going to come back there, and that's going to create that content each month. Put it in there. Because as you let go, as these teachers and these things begin to come forward, let me tell you something. We're gonna put them on that network, and so we're gonna begin to take it to another level. And so, I mean, because what God then gave you with StreamYard, I mean, your whole program, presentation, and everything should go to another level. Yeah.
Amen.
And so take it, and then boom. So here it is. So now, and then we got content, and so we doing something good. But I just wanted to say that, and because if you don't see it, you're gonna let other things drift in, and you're gonna think this ain't important. Because why? You're not gonna leave a legacy. All your messages, if you don't archive them and put them in a place so people can watch them and listen to them when you're gone, they just vanished in the air. They're going into thin air. Yeah, Brother Joe was a great teacher. None of your stuff is here.
Yeah.
Could have written 20 books, but they're not written. You could have had 1,000, 1,500 sermons. Where is the teaching? That's why we didn't see the importance of media. We didn't see the importance of archiving. We didn't see the importance of spending this money, creating a revenue stream that could be used and passed from generation to generation. Come on now. And so here it is, you know. So when you see that God can do the impossible, just like you said with that car, well, tell me what he won't do. If he can use old boy like me, come on now. So, man, look here, we thank God today. I guess we didn't do too much teaching, but we set in place a structure that we can tie into. And so yeah, it's according to our hearts whether we're going to be successful or not, you know, because everybody don't want the same thing. So some people want a little ice cream. Some people want a lot of ice cream in their bowl, you know. And so I'm one of those guys that, I'm going after what God has already given me. You see what I'm saying? And so everybody's, you know, got their flavor or whatever, but this is my flavor. And so, you know, God has given me the ability to do what I'm doing. So I'm grateful and thankful. And so let's close with that, Brother Joe, with prayer. And then, you know.
It is written. I have already ordained it. It shall come to pass in intervals and in due seasons, said the Lord. I am watching over my word to perform it. And you are going to see the word of God come into manifestations in such degrees that goes beyond your imagination. And I'm watching over it, says the Lord, to see to it that it don't fall to the ground, that it will never return void, empty, disannulled, of no effect, but it shall certainly come to pass as I have ordained it. And I'm going to see it, said God, that it all come to pass. Not just one, all of it come to pass, for it pleases me. It pleases me, said God, to do exceeding and do abundantly above all you ask or think. And that anointing will rest upon you. And it'll rest upon those that connect themselves with you. And that anointing shall flow. It'll flow into all the earth. It'll bring water where there's dryness. It'll bring rivers where there is desert. It'll bring fruit where there's barrenness. Because I said it, said the Lord. It's done. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Glory.
Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. All right,
Glory to Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. It's awesome, man. I tell you, wow, Lord, have mercy to Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We just thank him, right? We thank the Holy Spirit right now. We thank him for Mother.
Yes, God. Yes. Hallelujah. Thank
him right now. Hallelujah. We just start a cut.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh God, we praise you.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, Lord Jesus.
Yes, Father.
Shout out, but she is
one.
Oh, Father, Mandandre Heshele.
We receive.
In the name of Jesus, release
you. We receive.
And upon
the Lama, Amen. Hallelujah.
All right, brother.
Hey, brother Herman, the car is on the way. So amen. Hey, my brother.
Praise God. Yes.
Amen. Yes, amen. 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 Oh, well, probably he was on there, but he just got his camera.
I'm still out here.
Bless okay, you. Good. I didn't see you. Okay, but anyway, man, we thank y'all guys, man, and y'all have a great day. And hopefully, we won't have any interruption next. We'll be in house and doing some things. So good, man. We thank God for it. And Prophet, I see you got your questionnaire, right? Hello. Oh, he cut off.
Now
you're
on mute.
Yeah, he's on mute. But anyway, okay, guys, y'all have a good one, man. Look here. And
all right.
All right, take care. All right, bye-bye. Bye.
Bless you.
Bye-bye.
All right, bye-bye.